Do you ever look for signs that you're on the right path? Do you ever want to hear a message from above that supports and guides you? I know I did, and I found out how. Listen in to this episode to hear what happened.
Welcome to Between Heaven and Earth, an internet radio talk show where we help you connect spirit and divine guidance. Lisa Kay, your host, brings you shows that can enhance and transform your life with tips and new ideas for more happiness, abundance, and better relationships. Lisa is an expert on intuition and can show you how to strengthen your inner guidance to empower yourself. Each show is positive and uplifting to inspire your day. Her guest speakers are specialists on self-help, positive thinking, spirituality, and conscious living. Be the best that you can be. With Between Heaven and Earth, conscious living for your soul.
When I first learned to work with my intuition, I did it through connecting to my angels. They are messengers that bring you divine signs and messages. Now, way back when I learned about intuition and that soft inner voice that gives us those messages, I figured that angels were safe. After all, they were in the Bible, right? Now, I still love angels and I believe that they do exist. I know angels are with us all of the time. Your intuition is their, quote, voice, so to speak, because they use your intuition as one of the ways to give you messages. By definition, angels are messengers of God. They exist to help us on our life's path, and they give us guidance as well as pass God's messages to us. Now, at first I learned how to hear my angels and then write down the words they were giving me. It was the first time I'd ever done anything like this. I wasn't sure what I would receive, if anything at all. Now, the idea is that you set your intention to get a message from them and then ask them a question. It's very similar to using my intuition on-demand technique. Now, I remember learning how to do this and then sitting down to try it. And I was wondering, is this real? Maybe I'm not going to get anything. I half expected it to be gobbledygook. And I was super surprised that it wasn't. Now, the messages didn't come as like an instant download. In fact, the words came very slowly. They came so slowly, I didn't really know if in the end they were going to make any sense at all. But I didn't rush it. And I just wrote down the words as they were coming like dictation, and I went back to read them. Now, angel messages have certain characteristics just like intuition. And what I love about them is that they're always gentle, loving, never mean or scary. And they seem to have a warm vibration to them. And when I did this, it felt warm, it felt calm. So it started like this. I asked my angel, "Are you really there? What do I do to hear you?" And this is what my angel gave to me. One or two words at a time, then a pause, then another word or two, and so on. "Speak to me. Open to your awareness. Open your heart. Listen to me. When you hear me, you will know me." And that was it. And it was so slow that I really didn't know whether it made any sense at all. But when I read it back again, "Speak to me. Open to your awareness. Open your heart. Listen to me. When you hear me, you will know me." I was shocked, to say the least, but I was really happy I received a message, and it was warm, it was inviting. Now, a few months later, after practicing this every day, I received more. And again, it would come slowly, but when I started to read it, it was sentences that made sense. "Your eagerness is divine. Your nobleness is good. God's own love for you is grand, and He is still with you. Start thinking of the best way to approach me through prayer, divine love, and faith. You can pause and I will be waiting for you. Faith and patience is trust." I love that last part. Faith and patience is trust. So these were the messages that I was receiving through my angels from my creator, all that is, and God. And eventually, as time went by, and I worked with connecting with my angels, my trust grew. I still love angels, and my angels in particular. They have been with me always, and I've relied on them many times to support me and give me divine guidance. They've been there in my toughest, most scary moments in my life and gotten me through all those tough times. They were there when I thought I was going to die from endocarditis, which is a heart infection. I had just been admitted to the hospital the night before because my symptoms had gotten worse, and my new doctor, who figured out what was wrong with me, put me in the hospital right away. Immediately, they gave me intravenous antibiotics to kill the bacteria in my blood. But I had a bad reaction to the medicine, and they had to stop giving it to me. The doctors and nurses were in a little bit of a flurry, well, because that didn't work. The next morning, I was lying in my hospital bed, and I ached from head to toe. My big joints, my hips, my knees, my shoulders were screaming in pain. And I figured, I guess that's what happens when you have a systemic bacterial infection. I was so weak. I knew I couldn't sit or stand up. And I prayed and asked for my angels to help me and just be there with me. And just then, I looked down and I saw all over my hospital gown was written the word angel over and over again. I hadn't noticed it before. And then I heard softly but clearly, "You'll be okay." And my mind and my body immediately calmed down. And I was okay in the end. They found another antibiotic that my body could tolerate. And my angels were there when I thought my husband was going to die in 9/11. He was outside right under the building that had collapsed just after it was hit by the plane. I knew he was out on the street in front of the building when I watched it fall on the TV news broadcast. I didn't know where he was at the time when the building fell. I just knew he was out there, outside, in front of that building. And that massive structure that was a quarter of a mile high fell. And I was thinking, where did that all go? It's so big. Where could you stand where you'd be safe? And I was frozen with fear and I realized, oh my God, what if he was there under the building? And I prayed and my angels were there to keep me calm and be in the moment for what seemed like an eternity. Until he called me to tell me he was okay. They are there with me now, and they're always here with me, and it is so comforting. Now, I don't talk too much about angels and intuition because ultimately, if you believe in them or not, your intuition is there to give you information you wouldn't normally get using your thinking mind. But I know that believing in something outside of me surely has made my intuition stronger and easier to trust. Now, I do know we can hear our angels and get signs and messages from them. They have for me once I learned how, over and over again. Now, if you have an angel story, I'd love to hear it. Just reply to me in an email that I might have sent you or go to my website at lmk88.com and just click on that little question mark and you can send me a message. And if you'd like to know how to access your intuition, maybe to help you make better decisions, you can also sign up there at lmk88.com and get the free guide. I'm Lisa Kay, and you've been listening to Between Heaven and Earth, Conscious Living for Your Soul. Thanks for listening, everybody.